leave this place. I won't let you wake him. I won't let you wake him. Him forever. Telekar, a bad man who sleeps inside these ruins. When he wakes, I'll be trapped here forever. I'll do everything I can to get away. I did not. Telekar's servants hurt those people. They don't like you if you aren't from here. When he wakes, he'll control them completely. Just like me. The Bone Scepter holds power over Telekar's monsters. Over me. I can't lie to you. Besides, lying is wrong. One of Telekar's victims. But I don't have to be. If you can free me before he wakes, I'll leave. Then he'll go back to sleep forever. Hooray! Follow me inside the ruin. We don't want the Shades to hear us. They're his spies, you know. Quiet in here. Telekar's servants don't like things with blood inside them. And they really don't like noise. There's a big sparkly door inside the Constellation Room. It's this big lock Vistari made to keep him asleep inside. She doesn't come around anymore. I think that's why the door isn't so sparkly. Telekar's wife. They fought and fought because he was a bad man and she was a good woman. But she thought she could change him. When she realized he'd always been bad, she locked him in here, but the lock grew weak, and now he's waking. Vistari left three of the things we need in special rooms around the ruins. The fourth is stuck inside some of Telekar's servants. If you smash them open, I won't tell. But about all the pieces, I don't know how to make them work together. I'm sorry. That's easy. The morning room, the smelly room, and the forbidden room. But don't worry, I can keep you safe. We should just go there. I'll point out what we need. I can distract Telekar's servants. Point the bone scepter at one of them and I'll blind it. Then you can smack it until it falls down. Don't worry, it's not like you're hurting it. They get back up again, eventually. Oh, all right. The most important thing is the book Vistari wrote in when she locked the door. We need to find that so we know what to do in the Constellation Room. There's an old skull Telekar stole from Menemarco. Then there's a glowy vial. I don't know what's inside, but if you listen real close, you can hear whispers. Oh, and the Milky Rocks. You'll find those inside some of Telekar's servants. I don't like... All the servants used to live in the cages. But Vistari brought that old skull back here. I'm sure of it. Find all the pieces we need. Always when Vistari carried it back from the Constellation Room. Once we find all the pieces we need. We Behold, the Forbidden Room. I come here to think sometimes. It's where Vistari left the book she wrote in when she put Telecar to sleep. Pieces. We should go to the Constellation Room and put Telecar back to sleep. something's happening. I think it's working.
How dare you intrude within my... What? It's
no!
You!
No! Let me go!
You there! Explain yourself. What are you doing in my home? Who are you? Why have you invaded my home? The Shades defend my home from thieves. Neither I nor my servants bear any interest in the living. My work concerns one who died long ago. And now, I would know why this creature travels with you. Simple-minded thing. Those wards haven't contained me for decades. I remain within by choice. Now, I'm at a critical juncture in my research, and I need this creature to complete it. If you interfere, I'll drive you from my home. Now, be gone.
No, please! I don't want to stay here!
You dare interrupt me? Kalian, my son, see to this intruder. Again, you trouble me at a critical juncture. What must I do to hasten your departure? Attempting to restore my son, despite your interruptions. That creature is a piece of him, an imperfect piece. If I reunite flesh and spirit, I can revive my son. He's my son. I'd do anything to restore him to a fraction of himself. With refinement, I can make him whole again. Vastari thought this hubris. If she hadn't left this world, I'd try to make her understand. That we could one day be a family again. I needed time to refine my methods, and time I have had. And now I have his spirit. I don't wish to harm this creature. But without the bone scepter to control it, I must resort to cruder methods. You what? That scepter is crafted from my own bones. It can bind the creature to his immortal husk. Once Kalian's wounds knit, I'll summon him here. You must bind the creature to his husk. Set things to how they should be.
No.
You feared I would raise an undead army to march through Gratwell? My wife and I spurned Manimarco for a reason. But in return for binding this creature to my son's husk, I pledge we will remain within our home forever. He was young when he had his accident. Too young. The creature you've met can't fully comprehend the world around it. Unless properly supervised, it could harm itself or others without knowing what it did. No, to set it free would be a cruelty. Kalian is my son. I needed all his remains to craft the husk, so I had to use my own for the scepter. To command a spirit, use a focus made of its bones or those of its close relatives. Basic necromantic principle. I broke through Vastari's ward just under a century ago. I have remained here ever since, attempting to restore what remained of my family. I will never leave, as long as Kalian remains at my side. This is my home.
No, please. You can't. can't make me be a monster again. I don't want to be here anymore. It hurt when I was a monster. It hurt worse than these chains. I want my father to sleep so I can go away. I don't know. I wish you could use the bone scepter on him. Point it at his body. There, on the throne. And tell him to go to sleep. Then I could finally leave. Far away from here. Somewhere safe and warm. Somewhere where I'd have friends. You did it! I'm free! I'm finally free! Thank you. Thank you! I don't know, but whatever it is, I'll be far away from here. Telekar can't hurt me anymore. Here, I can open a portal so you can be with your friends. Tell them I'm sorry about the Shades. As long as they stay away, they should be fine.
Soldiers hadn't touched the bone scepter, we wouldn't be in this mess.